big smile.
Maybe it was Ty Campbell's smile. Maybe it was his courage. Maybe it was this memorable moment crossing the finish line in Central Park while cradled in his father Lou's arms.
Who's so strong?
Whatever it was, Ty captured hearts. For the last 2 years, the small town of Pauling has connected the world.
We get comments from Australia, Norway, Germany.
Ty's mom, Cindy, started a blog after she learned her son had cancer.
I've been crying for what feels like an eternity. But in between my tears, I have an overwhelming sense of freedom.
Cindy poured all of her emotions into her blog, and strangers from across the globe took notice. Many responded with gifts and kind words.
We read the comments to Ty because it makes him happy.
Through more than 20 surgeries and 200 nights in the hospital, every breakthrough, every setback along Ty's journey has been posted.
The blog has been, for me, very therapeutic.
But Cindy's blog has also become therapeutic for others who have been inspired to give their own children more hugs, more love, more time.
It's awesome. It makes me so happy to know that kids are having more fun because of Ty.
Just days ago, Ty celebrated his 5th birthday. Around the same time, the family was given devastating news.
Today we were told that there are no more treatment options for Ty, that his MRI Saturday night shows progressive leptomeningeal disease in 3 different areas.
Yesterday, when we taped this interview for a story we hope to air down the road, Ty couldn't walk. He had a high fever. We didn't want to disturb his rest and didn't set foot in his room.
He's suffered too much, and I can't allow that anymore. Maybe this time is what we needed to learn and to find the ability to say no more.
Today, the 5-year-old known across the world as Super Ty passed away. But Lou and Cindy are determined to keep his smile, his courage, his legacy alive by shining a light on childhood cancers and working for a cure. In Pauling, Mark Santia, News 4 New York.